Hey, Charles Hoffman here from Plugin Alliance. BrainWorks has just released BX Aura, a multi-purpose reverb plugin with 5 unique algorithms. There's a drive section to apply saturation, and a gate to maintain clarity and apply creative pumping effects. You also have a modulation section to break up unwanted resonances and apply chorusing effects, as well as an EQ to shape the tonality of your reverb. To demo BrainWorks' BX Aura, start a free Megaplan trial using the link below. This will give you access to all of Plugin Alliance's products for 30 days. BX Aura is an easy-to-use, modern reverb intended to act as a go-to plugin when creating spatial effects. There's been a lot of demand to add a comprehensive, do-it-all reverb to the Plugin Alliance catalog. I'll play some audio examples to hear how BX Aura sounds, and then we'll walk through the plugin's controls.
Nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul. Nobody gonna tell me different. You got my heart. You got my love.
Switching through algorithms is the fastest way to get a different sound from BX Aura. Space is the default algorithm. It creates the perception of a big, lush space that's echoey at the start and has natural amplitude modulation. The left and right channels are processed independently to create a wide reverb that preserves the stereo image of the input signal.
You got my heart. Nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul. Nobody gonna tell me different.
Space sounds great when applied to soundscapes, synths, and other sounds that need to fill up the stereo field. Soft is an algorithm with subtle early reflections and an attack phase that delivers a soft, smooth, and pad-like sound.
You got my heart. Nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul. Nobody gonna tell me different.
You can experiment with the soft algorithm on pianos, background vocals, and pads. The echoes algorithm is like a combination of a delay and reverb. It lets you create echo effects that are impossible in a real environment.
You got my heart. Nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul. Nobody gonna tell me different.
Some use cases for this algorithm include adding rhythmic complexity to guitar solos and creating otherworldly sound effects. The reverse algorithm creates swelling echoes that sound like the signal is played in reverse, while the reverb tail still decays naturally.
You got my heart. Nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul. Nobody gonna tell me different.
This algorithm is a great way to highlight ad-libs and other one-shot sounds. The complexity of the reverb tail can add a lot of tension to tracks, making it a great choice for buildups as well. Finally, we have the room algorithm. This can be used for general reverb purposes, recreating the sound of realistic physical spaces.
You got my heart, nobody gonna take it over. You got my soul, nobody gonna tell me different.
To control the length of the reverb tail, you can adjust this decay knob. By default, the decay time is displayed in seconds, but you can sync the decay to the tempo of your project. This will lead to more musical results.
One last time, baby. One last time.
Size affects the size of the virtual space that BXAURA emulates. A small size might make your signal appear like it's in a small chamber, while a large size can sound like it's placed in a cathedral. One of the unique things about the size knob is that if you turn it in real time or automate this feature, it will lead to pitch shifting effects. You can use this to create transitions, swells, and buildups. The mix knob allows you to blend the dry, unprocessed, and wet reverberant signals together. When you want to add a unique reverb effect to a single track, you can insert BXAURA directly onto it and adjust the mix knob to taste. This is generally faster than setting up an aux track. However, using an aux track is a good way to save CPU when processing multiple tracks. If you apply BXAURA to an aux, you'll turn the mix knob to 100% and modify the presence of reverb by adjusting send levels. There's also a little lock icon beside the mix text that locks the value of the mix knob in place when switching between presets. This width knob works a little differently than on other BrainWorks plugins. At 100, the left and right channels are panned hard left and right. As you adjust the knob to 0, the channels appear in mono in the center of the stereo field. Negative values cause each channel to play through the opposite speaker. You can also pan the reverb while maintaining the width you've selected. Pre-delay helps separate the reverb from your dry signal by delaying the onset of the reverb. This is most apparent on a one-shot like a snare hit. Increasing the pre-delay can be a quick fix if your reverb sounds like it's conflicting with your dry signal. Just like the decay knob, you can sync the pre-delay time to the tempo of your project. For example, you could delay the reverb by an eighth note. Diffusion creates a dense blob of echoes at the reverb's input, which increases the initial echo density and beefs up otherwise sparse reverb tails. You can use this feature when processing thin sounds to give the reverb more body. There's a decay time multiplier built into BXAURA that allows you to shorten the decay time of low and high frequencies. Below the low crossover, the decay time is multiplied by a value at or below 1, resulting in a reduced low-end decay time. The same concept applies to the high band. Frequencies above the crossover are multiplied by the high multiplier, reducing the decay time of high frequencies. Adjusting the decay time of your lows and highs can help you confine your sound to a designated space within the mix and enhance clarity without completely removing your lows and highs. This tends to sound quite natural. When audio flows through BX Aura, it runs through various processing modules. One of these modules is the reverb core, where the reverb is generated. The freeze function mutes the signal entering the reverb core and creates an endless reverb tail from the current audio material. In this state, all of the plugin's features remain active. However, any features that affect the signal before the reverb core will not affect the sound, like pre-delay. You can combine this with the pitch shifting effects of the size knob to create some pretty cool effects. There's a built-in low cut and high cut filter. You can apply the filters before or after the plugin's reverb core. When I freeze the track, you'll hear that the filters only affect the sound when set to post. To the left, there's a modulation section that can break up unwanted resonances by gently low-passing the reverb. High amount values can lead to chorusing and pitch drifting effects, while rate adjusts the modulation rate. High rate values tend to make the modulation applied sound more noticeable. You'll be able to hear this effect most clearly when you freeze the reverb. Enabling the drive section adds odd harmonic distortion and saturation to the reverb. Turning up the drive knob increases the presence of harmonic distortion, which can lead to a warmer and crunchier sound. There's three drive modes. A is an all-round distortion with presence that keeps the lower frequencies mostly intact. B is noisier and pronounces high frequencies, making it great for creating lo-fi sounds. C drives your bass and can lead to somewhat chaotic effects depending on the sound. The LED meter indicates the amount of distortion applied to the sound. The brighter it gets, the more distortion you're applying. When set to pre, the signal runs through the drive module after the pre-EQ and before the reverb core. When set to post, drive is applied immediately after the reverb core, but before the post-EQ. Again, this has significant implications when using the freeze function. The gate built into BX Aura is incredibly useful. In gate mode, you can use it to apply gated reverb effects to drums. You can also switch the module into duck mode, reducing the level of reverb when the dry signal plays. This allows you to create massive, in-your-face reverbs that avoid muddying the original signal. To clear up the difference between each mode, the signal below the threshold will be reduced in level when using gate. In duck mode, the signal above the threshold will be reduced in level. By default, the reverb is completely muted when one of these processors engages, but you can change that by increasing the floor level. Instead of the audio completely cutting out, it will just be reduced in level. There are attack, hold, and release settings. Attack adjusts the time it takes for the gate to open. Hold forces the gate to remain open for a certain period, which can help reduce stuttering effects. Release adjusts the time it takes for the gate to close. The external sidechain button allows you to trigger the gate using another track in your DAW. Up top, there's a bypass switch and a UI scaling feature. You can undo or redo parameter changes. It's also possible to copy the plugin's current settings to a different bank. Just click Copy, navigate to the new bank, and then click Paste. This allows you to experiment with different plugin settings without losing your work. If you don't like where the sound is going, you can just reset the bank. You also have a wet gain control that allows you to adjust the level of the wet signal. The rectangle icon in the top right corner allows you to hide or show the drive and gate sections. To demo BrainWorks' BX Aura, start a free Megaplan trial using the link below. This will give you access to all of Plugin Alliance's products for 30 days. If this video helped you out, give it a like and subscribe to the Plugin Alliance YouTube channel for more walkthroughs like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.